Welcome back to Red Dead Redemption, guys. We just met up with Mary, who I gathered was like an old flame. And apparently Arthur wasn't good enough for her family. So they, you know, they kind of split them up in the end. I'm guessing Mary had an ultimatum where she had to choose a family or Arthur. Obviously went with her family. She was about to get married. I think she said that she did get married, but her partner, her husband, died of pneumonia. So now she's a widow and needs Arthur's help because her brother Jamie has joined some mad gang. So yeah, here we are, off to find Jamie, see what he's gotten himself into. Hopefully he isn't dead. That would be rather morbid. Don't want to be the one that has to tell Mary about that. But yeah, Arthur got a trim. He's looking pretty good, I have to say. Looking much better, I think. Happy days. I didn't actually think you'd be able to cut his hair. I thought you could just customise his beard and that. But no, he can have a full on sort of trim up with his hair. Good stuff. I'm gonna head over there now to Jamie. Ghost is a little guzzlet, I'm telling you. She's constantly hungry, possibly pregnant. I think she's a girl anyway. I'm pretty sure she is. Pretty sure she is. Arthur doesn't seem hungry or anything, so that's all good. Better put the gun away. And get ourselves off to help this Jamie dude out. Might have some random encounter along the way or whatever. What I'm going to try and do is, like, whenever we're on our way back to camp, is just pick some food up. So just hunt whatever I come across, basically, on the way back to camp. And then at least we're not going back. We'll never go back empty-handed that way. But thank you for all of your support on this playthrough. You guys seem to be really enjoying it. I have to say, it's probably been my best playthrough yet, I think, on my channel. Yeah, it's good that you guys have enjoyed it, because I really love this game. I've recorded now a fair few episodes, so I've recorded, like, this on the back of episode 9, 10, and 11. So yeah, it's good. It's good to carry on. What the hell happened here? Oh no, that's sad. Damn. Oh, we got some brandy, some venison as well. Not bad. Shame about the horse though. That's really sad, to be fair. But, off we pop, again. This person here looks like they're drunk. Just bear with me a second, guys, I have to mute my microphone just for a sec.
Twisted my ankle something fierce. Think you could give me a ride?
Yeah, sure. Hop on.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you. Might as well just have left me to walk.
Well, safe travels anyway.
Just can't never get a break.
a fool for love. Help a blind man. A dollar for your future. A dollar for your fate.
Here.
Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Thank you. Keep moving, sir. Keep moving. But don't move too fast.
Yeah. Okay, I will try to bear that in mind. Easy there. Slow up now. Thank you.
safety.
Shadow of safety.
Can I speak to the boy?
Arthur?
Hello, son. Your sister is very worried.
The boy has chosen a path, sir. The path to truth.
Well, I mean, his sister just wants to speak with him.
Arthur, I've chosen a path.
The boy has chosen a path. He's chosen safety. What path have you chosen, sir?
I'm still searching, I guess.
We are all searching. Chelonianism is about searching. What do we search for, do you think?
I don't know. Safety? Safety and meaning?
Jamie knows the truth. But of course, you may speak with him.
Exactly. If your teachings are so great, what harm can I do?
I'm not coming with you, Arthur!
Just come and speak with Mary, then make up your mind!
Chelonia.
Leave me alone, Arthur! I didn't ask for your help!
Sorry guys, I was just on the phone to my manager and I thought it's easier to just carry on. Oh no mate, no he's gotten away.
Please Arthur, I'm a man now, I found something, a calling.
You're just a kid, you're making a big mistake.
I'm not taking advice from you, you're an outlaw, you leave me alone, they're good people. I'm warning you, Arthur Morgan. Leave me alone.
He doesn't know what he's doing. At all.
Put that gun down.
But yeah, sorry about that, guys. I was basically just speaking to my manager on the phone.
I warn you, Arthur.
Come on.
I don't want to live anymore.
No.
Calm down.
Oh, no. Look, lightly hold RT.
Now calm down.
Oof, God, the tension then. Jeez.
Let's go go see your sister.
Okay.
Oh no. If he wants such a purpose, he can join our gang. Just stay at the camp and help out.
I don't know enough about it. But one thing I do know. There ain't no shame in looking for a better world.
I missed you, Arthur. Are you and Mary sweet on one another again?
Nope.
That's all a long time ago, son.
Come on.
Well, this wasn't how I thought today would turn out.
It's been a long time, Jamie Gillis. You were a kid last time I saw you.
Oh. Try to kill yourself. Bless him.
You know, you taught me how to ride a horse.
Too well, apparently. Salonia, though? Really? You'd fall for that?
They were very...
Sorry, guys.
Nice to me. They're decent.
Sure. Please tell me you didn't give them any money.
Of course I did. They rely on charitable donations.
Oh, God.
Jesus, Jamie, come on.
I just wanted to... Sorry, guys. My dog's snoring. Because he's a pig.
That's dead in the water.
With the turtle.
Shut up. All Father kept telling me was, you won't amount to anything. You're not enough of a man. I had to get away. I couldn't take it anymore.
Forgive me, but your father's a bully and a coward. Don't listen.
Ooh. Hey, don't talk about him like that.
What do you want me to say, Jamie? He's a good father? Nah.
A nice man?
He won't be happy I saw you.
Please send him my worst regards.
Thing is, he's right. I'm not good at anything.
Oh, no.
That ain't true.
Oh, it got back up. That's all right, then.
Don't think too hard.
It's good with horses.
Apples, I guess.
Apples?
Yeah, I love apples.
Oh, my God. You freak.
I was thinking more along the lines of carpentry or horses or something. But all right, go work in an orchard, then.
By that token, you must really like shooting and robbing people.
I only like shooting young idiots who run away from me when I'm trying to help them.
Father told me what you do.
I'm sure he did.
Hey, are you still with Dutch and what was his name? Hester?
Jose. Yep, still the same, sort of.
And Annabelle and Bessie?
I'm afraid they're dead.
Oh.
Shit. Maybe Mary did make the right choice.
No doubt. But none of it is anything like the nonsense you're reading in the newspapers.
So, are you two getting back together?
I told you, no. Just ask me for a favor.
You know Barry Linton's dead? Pneumonia.
You told me.
So the door's open, so to speak.
Jesus Christ.
Past, different people now.
She's not. And you seem just the same.
Well, except for that bomb new haircut, am I right?
She was always too good for me. Now, let's just get you back to your sister. She's waiting at the station for us.
Wow, look at the scenery right now, guys. Oh, oops. Yeah, this horse is like constantly hungry. Look, as soon as I say that, hungry again. You have no laugh. Oh, she must be going away if she's in there. Let's just hitch. Let's hitch her up.
We going in then?
Yep, we are. Come on. kid just needs.
Make it quick or I might run off again.
All right. Come on.
Father's been very sad.
Father wouldn't know sadness if it died in his bed.
Ooh.
But I'll come home for you.
My boy. My sweet boy. Come on. Oh, Arthur. Thank you. Thank you.
It's good to see you, Mary.
And you, Arthur. And you.
And that's it. Just like that, they're gone. Well, not quite.
Oh, Peng? I'll never change.
Oh.
I know that.
At least we helped. Did we have to do that? No. Not at all. We didn't have to do anything.
Feel
but
like
we did.
The luckiest man alive and
oh.
Feel like a fool. That woman confuses me and plays me for a fiddle like no one else will have. I trust I will not make a god-awful fool of myself once more, but somehow, I imagine I shall.
Yeah, you will, Arthur. You'll find a new bay instead. Alright, so we're in the town for a bit, so let's, let's check this out. Oh. I might go and check out this question mark. This is what what's her name told us about Tilly.
It's me. What are you looking at?
Okay there, mister.
What do you want? This is private. Get along.
You can now rob the shop's side business. How? Not sure I'm feeling that. Let's try and be legit for a bit. Earn some money. And all that. What's this here? Let's buy us. Oh, the newspaper seller. Maybe he's not selling right now. Evidently.
Look here. You want to catch another center bounty hunter? Take a gander at the poster there.
A woman? Oh, there's that.
Evening. Okay, that's enough now.
Shall I piss him off? No, never mind. Ellie and Swan.
Nasty individual.
Wanted alive for questioning, known as the Black Widow. She has seen, been seen in the blah 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 blah. What did she do?
They say she's sleeping rough near Cumberland Falls.
Why don't they go and investigate then? Lazy bastards.
Okay.
I ain't gonna complain because it gives us something to do. And we get paid for it as well, so. It's a win-win for us, guys. But yeah, let's carry on. So where are we headed? Over here. It would seem. Okay. Well, there you go. Alright, horse. I hope you're up for a good...
you good, girl?
Good run out. That's what we're gonna do. I hope we unlock like more towns and stuff. Like just different, you know. What's the difference here? One of these is a hotel, right? That's the hotel in it. Hotel, general store. We can now rob the general store. Or the general store's side business or something.
Have a nice evening.
Rude. Why is it so hungry all the time, guys? Help me.
Hey, you there. Can I have a word?
Sure.
This little crow don't look like one of ours. Does he?
Well, clearly I am in the wrong part of town.
Well, if this one ain't been riding, Jerry Duck. This is a no good bastard. Make him pay.
Get out of here, guys. I don't want to shoot people and then I'm gonna... Yeah, I ran away from that. Sorry to do that, guys, but, you know... Didn't mean to be a pussy, but... Sometimes it just has to be done. I swear my dog is doing everything to annoy me today, guys. He's now started to freaking lick his paw. I'll tell you what, he's going to be in so much trouble if he carries on. Whoa, we're rendering off the road. But yeah, we'll go and sort this out, and then I'm sorry that I had to mute quite a bit of this video. Oh my god, she's hungry again. What the fuck? What am I supposed to do here, guys? That is a wagon, right? Yeah. So unfortunately, they don't have cars. Hungry again. I think that's what it means, anyway. I'm pretty sure it means hungry. Pretty sure it does. Look at how long Arthur's gone without food and all the shit he's done. He hasn't eaten since they were last in camp. I'm actually giving up with the horse, it can just be fucking hungry now. It's starting to annoy me. Should probably get a lantern out. Wrong one. Wow, didn't pick it up. That's better. What time are we on? Thought it was pretty late. We're going bounty hunting. At least we'll bring some money back to camp. I'll take these. Don't know if you can eat wolf, but I'm sure we can use the fur and stuff, the pelt and whatnot. That looks pretty nice, like. Probably can eat it, can't they? I'm presuming. Stow it. Yep. Trust me, I'm ready for anything else.
Easy there, girl.
Yeah, it's okay. I just thought she's wanted alive. I'm probably not gonna fit her on this horse.
You can't turn me in. This ain't just.
You robbed and murdered your way across half the country.
It's all lies. I ain't never been more than 5 miles from home.
You keep lying, you're gonna make me angry for it.
Yeah, in fairness, I don't really fancy eating wolf. I can't imagine it being very nice, so I'm just gonna throw that. We can still keep the pelt, I think. No. Don't know where to look for, I forgot. There we go. Camp. See the fire. This has got to be a...
that there's a bounty hunter. Get him!
Kellyanne, I'm sorry, but I'm gonna make you go with help.
Ow. What kind of man are you? Puny!
No shit, I killed her. Oops. retry from checkpoint, yeah. Shit, I didn't mean to do that. She came at me with a knife, so, you know, I kind of panicked a little bit, like. Shit. Oops. She is very close to catching fire right now.
You are a piece of work.
Oh, she's got cheese and coffee. Right. No, I didn't mean to pick him up. Come on. Oh, there's stuff on there too. Yep.
Now the fun starts.
Alright, we can't take any of that. That's not good. I see tin cans. Ah, there we go. I say, man. Corned beef. So look at what else you've got here. Canned salmon. Apple for horsey. Yeah, for ghost. Wait, we can't take it. Can't carry anymore. Got the stranger. Got some bourbon. The stranger again. What about in this little box? Nothing? Okay, we're all good. Got some stuff for you.
You got a ride ahead of you.
Alright. Have some celery. Oh. Shit, you stupid dumb fucking horse. We better head back to camp after this, because, yeah. At least we're not going back completely empty-handed, like, we've got some good stuff.
Oh dear. What came over me? Did I just do those things? It's a horrible blur. But I see blood. There's blood everywhere. It won't come out. I'm not like that. I'm a good girl. Really. I promise I am. You believe me, don't you? Don't you, mister?
Not really. I'm not gonna hit her because she's not bothering me that much, really. Yeah, she's just chatting. It's quite interesting to.
I have an illness. A fever of the brain. I've done bad things, but a jail. A jail ain't where I belong. A sanatorium, maybe. Get me help, mister. Please? Save me from the sheriff, and moreover, from myself.
Nah, you don't deserve. She just murdered that guy in cold blood, like, you're in a jail, bitch.
But a big, strong man like you, you'd set me straight. Wouldn't you, mister? Put me on the straight and narrow? I hate you, you sad sack of shit. I wish I'd cut your belly open and shown you your guts.
Okay.
I wish you'd die.
He said that to the horse, by the way. Not her. He's not, like, sadistic. She's shut up again now. We're almost there. I think. We should get some money for this anyway, so should be good. God, calm down. Here we are. I've never been to see the show yet. Like, there's shows that you can go to just on the left there. Never done that one yet. Have to have a look into it.
Hey there, mister.
Hello.
Howdy.
Oh, hell.
Just leave me out. Good to see you back.
I can't take this.
Holy shit.
Morning to
you. No, no, no.
We're coming up on the jailhouse. Anything else you want to try on me?
Just get me there. You're no fun at all.
I'm afraid I ain't.
You order a lady killer here, Sheriff?
Yeah, we did. Put her in the cell, won't you?
I protest my innocence. I protest my innocence.
She might be a little shaken up. She lost another feller out by the falls.
Poor dear.
Men just got a habit of dying around you, don't they, Mrs. Swan?
I hope you'll be comfortable, miss.
She'll be fine. Now come get your money off the desk here. The Black Widow herself. This town's so starved of women, I'm sure she could find herself a husband yet.
Yeah, that's cowboys for you.
Indeed.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, mate. I was just looking at that.
So, it seems this town's got more pressing problems than outlaws. Gonna take some time off posting bounties, impose law and order on the streets.
That man has a heart of stone. It's silly to keep me locked up in here. I mean, what am I gonna do? Just little old me. Let me out. Could exercise a little.
I'm immune to your charms, Mrs. Swan.
It's so boring in here. Can we have some fun, Sheriff?
Make sure you'd kill the sheriff. Him again. What's all you, dude?
Hello, mister.
Hey, brother. Can I get a buck, mister?
Sure.
Thank you. Oh, thank you, mister.
No worries, dude. It's chill. Right, I best end this episode and I'll be back in episode 13.